I'm Justin Ziegler of Jay-Z Helps, a Florida injury law firm. Today I'm going to talk about why I believe Disney will pay somewhere around $10 million to settle the claim if one is filed, or even if one is not made, of the boy who was killed by the alligator at the Seven Seas Lagoon at Disney's Grand Floridian Hotel. Stay tuned and watch the entire video so you can see why I think that Disney will pay somewhere around $10 million to settle this case. Jay-Z Helps, a Florida injury law firm. The first thing to understand is the law in Florida says if a business is negligent and their negligence or carelessness caused the death of a minor child, each parent can recover money for their mental pain and suffering from the death of the child. Now, if this case went to a lawsuit, there's a chance, as I've said before in other videos, that a judge could dismiss the case. There's also a chance that a lot of liability could be found on the parents. So why do I believe that Disney would pay somewhere around $10 million? And when I say $10 million, there's a large range on either, actually on the lower side of that they may pay. The reason why is because Disney markets themselves as the happiest place on earth. When this story broke, it hit every single news source that I know of, CNN, Fox, all the big news stations, and it was all over them. And it wasn't good for Disney's image. If this case did not receive worldwide media attention, I think Disney would take a totally different stance on this case and offer a lot less. One of the reasons that I think Disney would pay way above what I call the fair value of the case is because if you go online and look at all the comments to these videos and articles about this death online, you're going to notice that I would say about 80% or so are against Disney, putting fault on Disney. And then you do have about 20% of the comments from what I've seen are people blaming the parents and saying also that alligators exist in the wild. What if it had been a snake? What if it had been some disease in the water? I'm going to quickly explain how we would calculate the fair value of this case if it wasn't a PR nightmare for Disney. The first step would be you look at the full value of the parents' damages, which is primarily mental pain and suffering in this case. You look at past jury verdicts, and they range anywhere per parent from about $1 million or so up to one court where a mother lost her 20-year-old child, awarded $5 million to the mother. It was actually a jury that awarded the $5 million, and the defendant appealed, and the appeals court, which would be the same appeals court if the Disney case, if a lawsuit was filed and it went to an appeal, the appeals court said $5 million for the mother was reasonable. So if this was a typical case, let's just say that $3 million per parent would be reasonable. 3 million times both parents, two would be $6 million. So we're at the full value right now of the case. However, again, since Disney has PR issues in this case, public relations issues, I'll put the value at $5 million for each parent as the full value of the case before looking at any things that, if a lawsuit was filed, could decrease the value of the case. After all, I think Disney will pay on the upper end again of the full value of the parents' pain and suffering because they don't want this case back in the news. After that, what you do is you look at what is the chance that if a lawsuit was filed, a judge would dismiss this case prior to trial even, without even getting to trial, or a jury would say that Disney did nothing wrong, meaning, again, alligators exist in the wild, they didn't possess the animal, they didn't contribute to this. I think there's somewhere around a 50% chance that this case would get dismissed prior to trial or a jury would find that Disney did nothing wrong. Although, again, this is a very unfortunate incident that happened. Again, if this was a typical case, you would take the parents $3 million each for pain and suffering, multiply that times two for the parents, that would take it to $6 million. You'd cut it in half, or Disney's claim adjuster would cut it in half, and say we're at about $3 million right there. The third step is to look at the parents' percentage at fault for arguably not better watching their child. I would say that there's about a 50% chance on them, or 50% of the fault would be placed on the parents. So you would take the $6 million that I initially said, cut it by 50% for the chance of Disney, the case getting dismissed before trial, or Disney winning at trial, and another 50% on the parents for arguably not watching their kid better. Maybe they should have known that alligators were in the lake. Maybe they should have been closer to their child when this happened. This would take the case from a $6 million case, cut it in half, to $3 million, cut it in half again for the parents' negligence. That would be $1.5 million, so $750,000 for each parent. However, this is not a typical case. This case has made worldwide news, and I don't think it's good for Disney's business. So I think Disney, for purposes of settlement, would be willing to not factor in the fact that a judge could dismiss the case, not factor in the parents' percentage of fault, and just try as quickly as possible to reach a settlement, to put this matter to bed, and to not go through the litigation process. And if the litigation process happened where the parents file a lawsuit, all the motions going back and forth in court would reach the media, and it would just be a constant thing in people's minds about Disney. Now, you're not going to hear about the settlement regardless of what it is. Why? Big corporations tend to insert confidentiality clauses in the settlement. They're not going to want it to be discussed. Essentially, they're buying their peace by paying, if they end up settling, and paying the parents money to settle the case. So given the fact that I think Disney wants this out of the media, I think they'll offer somewhere around $10 million to settle. Now, there's a chance the parents don't even want to make a claim. There's a chance the parents would accept a lot less just to get rid of this matter and not have to think about it, or think about it as little as possible. I'm sure they're going to be thinking about it for the rest of their lives. And again, it's a horrible situation that happens. When I saw a picture of the kid, my heart melted. I have a 2-year-old. I can't imagine the same thing happening to my child. Please give your comments below. I'd love to hear what you think, if you think I'm accurate with my estimation. And again, I said Disney will pay $10 million. Yes, there's a chance that they'll offer a lot less than that, but that number is a ballpark figure. Settlements are not an exact science. I think that if this was not a PR matter and it went to a lawsuit, I think the amount would be a fraction of $10 million, like I said earlier on. It could even be somewhere around $1.5 million or so. So have a beautiful day. Please subscribe to the video. Thank you so much.